At first, I'd like to thank organizer, professor, especially Professor Seo. Almost every year, this conference I attended. So I get many friends here from England, China, Japan. So nice to meet all mathematicians. Today I want to talk quantum type cohomologies on almost contact metric manifolds. This talk is already submitted many some I will give a reference. Last one. Oh, I submitted three papers, but still going on. 6 months ago, I submitted some, you know, the mathematicians, some good papers. Many people talk on quantum cohomologies, on symplectic manifolds. I initiate the not symplectic manifold, more generally, contact metric manifolds. I gather quantum type cohomologies. To do this, as an introduction, I want to talk on the maybe many people know the, already know the quantum cohomology, but I will just introduce some notion of quantum cohomology. M is a two n dimensional symplectic manifold, symplectic form, non-degenerate closed two form. J is almost complex structure, tamed by omega. Then we all geometer and topologists know the Riemann surface, genus G. Topologically we know, geometrically we know a little, but algebraic geometrically still very actively work on Riemann surface. So we want to study on symplectic manifold using this Riemann surface. So we consider two-dimensional submanifold, integral submanifold inside in some two-dimensional homology class. So many mathematicians and symplectic geometer and topologist, all Riemann surface is a Kähler manifold, so has a complex structure. We already mentioned this symplectic manifold has a almost complex structure. So we want to study from this Riemann surface to this kind of map. This is a pseudo holomorphic map, means DU is already mentioned, this is a holomorphic, commute with this equation, extended Cauchy-Riemann equation. And this two-dimensional homology fundamental class is represented this homology class, this kind of thing. So we consider some moduli space, genus G, some K mark point in M representing homology class A is we call the all pseudo holomorphic curve from Riemann surface G, genus G, and K Mach point represent inside in here. We usually sigma G Mach point, and we U is some pseudo holomorphic map representing this homology class, integral homology class. Then this is a stable condition is here, some stable condition to compactify this moduli space. Then we have this moduli space using some index theory has a dimension 2C1M times A, evaluate A, first chunk class plus 2 minus 2G complex dimension, in this case C, M, N plus 6G minus 6 plus 2K has a dimension like this. So from here to the, we have a natural map here. M to the K. K is K product of K times. So this dimension is 2NK. We call the evaluation map. Evaluation map is this sigma G, G1, GK, U is just the evaluation map. G1, G, G, K, like this. This is M, K times product in here. So, from here, we get some Gromov-Witten invariant compactify and stabilize, and from this Gromov-Witten invariant G K M A here H homology group of M K from here to the some. This is in general not manifold, some ovipold has some here. Gromov-Witten invariant is defined like this. Some cohomology class is here. Then we already know that this evaluation map is here. So this is pulled back from cohomology integral G K M A evaluate this. This is a cohomology class over here and the integral of this. This is a Gromov-Witten invariant. Using this Gromov-Witten invariant, we can define the quantum product is a generalization of a usual curve product. You know the wedge product. So if alpha is in H K M, beta is H L M, we can define some kind of product. This is called quantum product. A is a two-dimensional homology class. Alpha star beta A. E to, I think there are many notations here. Q to the C1A over N. N is a minimal churn number of M. Q is a auxiliary variable degree 2N. So total degree is 2C1A. So this should be has a degree HK plus L minus 2C1A because this degree is 2C1A is here. So what is this? This class is defined by if alpha star A is a homology class, C is in H K plus L minus 2C1A in homology class. Evaluate this. You can pairing from this and this is, you can pair by integration. This is just, I already mentioned this. In this case, usually Riemann surface is a two-sphere rational curve. Otherwise, you should put in another condition. So zero, genus zero, so two-sphere, and three Mach point, M, A, alpha, beta, gamma, evaluation, this kind of thing in here. So gamma is a Poincaré duality. C is a gamma. If dimension is this is right direction. So to define the quantum product, you use this kind of Gromov-Witten invariant. Using this Gromov-Witten invariant, we can get some new homology called quantum homology. This kind of thing. This has some associative law. This multiplication is associative law. Satisfy associative law. This is, you can interpret by the differential equation, so called WDBB equation. Also, that is a Pratt condition on the supermanifold. That is if and only if. That is some geometry, analysis, physics related. Using that associativity, WDBB equation, using that WDBB equation, that kind of some number theory in the number of the Schutte-Hornby curves representing some homology class, this thing. Physicists always get some that number. What is that number? That is related to the mirror symmetry, that number is. Also, this is a small quantum cohomology. Big quantum cohomology is defined by Gromov-Witten potential. Should define if you want to that big quantum cohomology, we should use some Gromov-Witten potential. If you know the H two-dimensional integral cohomology class has a base E zero, da 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 E to the lambda. This is a base of this ring. This is by co-product, this is a ring, has a ring structure. So formally, we denote E0T0 plus E lambda T lambda like this. This is a Gromov-Witten potential. All you know the potential come from the Gromov-Witten theory, come from this potential. H2M 1 over M pectoral and G, and we already mentioned this G on, maybe we mentioned the manifold is dimension N, 2N, so K I will write like this, K M A R tensor case product and E to the minus A times simplex form. There are many properties, some string equation, many things in, come from the, this Gromov-Witten potential. This kind of thing, last 10 years I did work on this area. After that, whole manifold is a simplex manifold. Still many people work on this. But today I want to introduce, nobody work on other dimension. 2m plus 1, some metric, and 1 and tensor type, and 1 form, and you know the geometry, this is a vector field, this kind of thing. I will introduce this and generalize this, everything. I already write three papers submitted some place, good journal. One is accepted, two is still going on. I will talk on this kind of thing. Maybe you geometers already know the, I will just recall. Almost contact metric manifold is pi meter xi, satisfying this thing. This is a smooth manifold, Riemannian manifold, and vector field, and neta is one form, satisfying this. Neta xi is 1, and pi is one type tensor, satisfying this. Pi square is minus identity plus neta tensor xi. And the metric is compatible with 1 and tensor, like this. From this almost contact metric manifold, we get fundamental two forms of this almost contact metric manifold defined like this. You already know this. This two form is satisfying this thing, means pi to the nth power which neta is 2n plus 1 dimension, top dimension, is non-vanishing. So that manifold is orientable. That's the basic property. Using this thing, the distribution on M, neta x is 0. This, then this stand, standard fundamental two form is invariant on one and type tensor phi. G is also on this. I want to use this distribution. I already mentioned this is if this is Riemann surface, this is Onum type tensor on M. M is almost contact metric manifold. We call this is J pi co-holomorphic map means like this, satisfying this. Then this co-holomorphic map is image is always inside into the distribution on this. This Onum type tensor is on the distribution. This is almost complex structure. Phi times phi composition phi is minus identity. So we get this distribution is n-dimensional complex vector bundle on M. The almost contact metric manifold is co-symplectic means just definition. The pi is fundamental two form is closed and theta is closed one form. This definition. Then M is called co-symplectic manifold. Almost contact manifold is says contact means this is derivative of theta one form is standard one form. This definition, you know, may turn or load this. In this case, M is a contact manifold. Then, one of type tensors has a standard, you know, the Nietzschenhaus, who is tensor, is defined like this. If Nietzschenhaus tensor is zero, we call this Onum type tensor is integrable. Also, if one of Nietzschenhaus tensor plus 2d neta tensor cosine, if this is zero, then we call this one of type tensor is normal. If manifold has an integrable co-symplectic manifold, we call this co-Kehler manifold. Integrable co-symplectic manifold. Normal condition and contact manifold. Then we call this Sasakian manifold. Then we get a, we already, this well-known result in reference 9, this M is co-Kehlerian if and only if this is a covariant constant. Sasakian if and only if, this kind of thing. My paper 4 and 5, we extended the pseudo-Holomorphic maps on symplectic manifolds to pseudo-co-Holomorphic maps on the co-symplectic and contact manifolds. And we investigate the moduli space of stable pseudo-co-Holomorphic maps that are representing some homology class, two-dimensional homology class. Also, we investigate Kolmogorov-Witten type invariant and quantum type product, quantum type cohomology of co-symplectic and contact manifold. I will introduce just the result. If M is a co-symplectic manifold, then for generic, there are many co-complex structure. For generic, almost co-complex structure pi, the moduli space of stable rational pi co-holomorphic maps representing some two-dimensional homology class that is a compact stratified manifold with a virtual dimension like this. You do not consider Mach point, just a rational number, so it is 2m. Quantum cohomology of M, quantum type cohomology of this co-simplex manifold has associative ring under the quantum type product pi defined by Gromov-Witten type invariants. And also we get a almost same result on the contact manifold. You see the order dimension contact manifolds has some, we define the co-holomorphic map and the moduli space, and that is smooth structure and the dimension, virtual dimension using adjacent index theorem, you can compute, and quantum type cohomology is associative under the quantum type multiplication. Also, you see the we have two almost contact manifold M1 and M2. Then we can consider M1 product N2. Then naturally product metric, we define product metric on this product manifold. Then this is not almost complex structure, one and tie. This is not. But defined like this, if we define like this, then J is almost complex structure on this manifold. Also, we have a fundamental two forms defined like, you know the fundamental two form is by definition we can compute like this. Then we have this lemma, this M G product metric J is already defined, omega is defined like this. Then this is almost complex structure, and this is compatible with almost complex structure, and this is skew symmetry, and two form is like this, and 2n is non-vanishing on M, so this is non-degenerate. Then if M1 and M2 is co-symplectic, then M is symplectic using this product structure. Then we can do the Gromov-Witten invariant quantum cohomology on here. Also, we can already define on co-simplex manifold on here. We can relate quantum type cohomology on M1 and M2 and M. You can relate. But and M1 and M2 is co-carrier, then product is carrier. Also, M1 and M2 is contact structure, but in this case, M is not symplectic. One is co-symplectic, another is contact, then it is not symplectic. So we can not compute quantum cohomology on 3 and 4 case. So in paper 4, we have this M1 and M2 is a compact co-symplectic manifold. Then two-dimensional homology is usually you see the M is a product. Also, this distribution on MI, DI is already mentioned. One form is zero decays. This is a complex vector bundle on MI. If this distribution is involutive, that namely integrable, then we have integral, maximal integral submanifold M1, M2. So you see the standard co-simplex manifold is a simplex manifold cross S1. This is a standard co-simplex manifold. This is simplex manifold. S1 is a standard. Co-simplex manifold. Then we can compute the moduli space is homeomorphic with this whole thing and N1 and N2 and torus in integrable case. Also, we can compute the quantum cohomologies like this using pi 1 n-type tensor, pi 2 n-type tensor. Torus is a standard Kerr manifold. Also, we can compute the Gromov-Witten potential on here. If I already mentioned di is a distribution, neta I x equals 0, that is a distribution associated with the one form neta I, then Tm is decomposed like this. Then almost complex structure on this manifold, actually we can define like this. And to get some two-dimensional homology class, we can use the Feni formula. The product formula is like this. H2 M1, H2 M2, H1 tensor H1 M2, like this. We can compute each component. Oof. Then yeah, the homology class is if M1 and M2 in this case moduli space is empty if A is non-trivial, because there is no non-trivial rational maps from sphere to torus. Also, first turn class we can compute like this by Whitney product formula. C1, D1, C1, D2, and C1. This is zero. So, and for two-dimensional homology class of the product A, we can divide like this. A1, A2, A3. This is pi I is a projection on each component, M1, M2, and T. Then J holomorphic map on this, because this is a simplex manifold. So J holomorphic map is complex linear, not NT. The projection is UI. Then we have this is J holomorphic map, is this each component is holomorphic on their almost complex structure. And the moduli space is compact stratified space with virtual dimension like this. We should take care this is not first term class on TM1 for the distribution, that is complex vector bundle. So C1, D1 makes sense, C1, D2. using the some index theory, you can compute like this. So naturally, you can correspondence. We have a correspondence like this. And as I already mentioned, the evaluation map is defined like this. We want to small quantum cohomology. So we have a three mark point each. Pseudo holomorphic map is a three mark point. So evaluate like this. Each component. Also, we can define the naturally, as usual, the Kromov-Witten type invariant, like this. All involved in some Onan type tensor, so we mentioned the Kromov-Witten type invariant, like this. And we can define the, from this definition, we can get this kind of nice, beautiful formula. On the product, Kromov-Witten invariant is each type, and take care this is torus. If A3 is not zero, then this is all zero. But if A3 is zero, all pseudo-holomorphic map is constant, otherwise empty. Also, for the cohomology of products, Kearney formula, we do not include the torsion part. We torsion quotient of torsion, so all free part of the cohomology. First chunk class of a complex number is already mentioned. It is quantum cohomology. Q1 is confirmed, D1. Q2 is confirmed, D2. And the quantum cohomology is like this. And quantum cohomology has a nice product structure. You see the, this is a symplectic manifold. This is a co-symplectic manifold, co-symplectic manifold. Quantum type cohomologies. This is quantum cohomology. And maybe I another thing is we consider symplectic manifold product almost contact metric manifold. In this almost contact metric manifold, we co-symplectic manifold is there, and contact manifold is there, and another is Kenwood manifold is another type is there. But we all consider this kind of thing. One is a symplectic manifold. Another is a almost contact manifold defined like this. One on metric is a product. Vector field is like this. In some sense, pullback of vector field from M2. Nita is pullback of one form on M2. And Onan type tensor is like this, defined like this. And fundamental two form is defined like this. Then we have some immediate consequence. We have this kind of result. So M1 is a symplectic manifold. If M2 is co-symplectic, then this is naturally co-symplectic structure. So we can do the Kromov-Witten type quantum cohomology and Kromov-Witten potential. If M2 is contact, then M is not contact or co-symplect. So we cannot do that kind of work. So quantum type cohomology product Riemann surface, and symplectic, another is co-symplectic. We do that kind of thing. So M is a product, one is a symplectic, another is co-symplectic. Then we have a moduli space, and you have a this relation between moduli space. Also, we have a same kind of process we can do. We have a almost same formula for the this is a Kolmogorov invariant. This is a Kolmogorov type invariant. This is a Kolmogorov type invariant. Also, do the quantum type cohomology, two definite quantum type cohomology. We consider two-dimensional homology class and Chern class. This is a simplex manifold, so we have a this is distribution, so we have a complex structure is here. So minimal Chern number is originally defined like this. N1, large N1, large N2 is defined like this. If alpha is in here, K1, K2 inside here, K1, K2, we see the HKM is a Quine's formula. This is just one part, one component. Beta is just another component on this HLM. Then we can also define the Kolmogorov-Witten type quantum product like this. First part, second part, like this. Component wise, alpha 1 tensor, beta 1, A1 is inside in here, already mentioned. And Kolmogorov-Witten invariant, we can define like this. So we can also define the Kolmogorov-Witten type using Kolmogorov-Witten type invariant. We can define the quantum cohomology, quantum type cohomology, and have this quantum type cohomology, quantum cohomology, quantum type cohomology product is this. To define the Kolmogorov-Witten type potential, we consider integral base of cohomology ring M1 and M2. Base is like this. Then we can formal monomial, we can define like this. This monomial, from this monomial, of course, we know the this tensor product has a base like this. EI is come from M1, FJ is come from M2. Tensor, this is the base of this product cohomology. So we have this Kolmogorov-Witten type potential. We can define like this. This is on M. M1 is defined like this. M2 is defined like this. Then we have Kolmogorov-Witten type potential on M. This kind of product. Kolmogorov-Witten type potential, Kolmogorov-Witten type potential, Kolmogorov-Witten potential. Related like this. That's nice, natural, we can guess, but we should justify by the proof. Just I have only 1 minute. I'll finish here.
questions?